As many of you know, starting in September, I will be away for a three-month period of renewal and sabbatical leave. This is typical for United Methodist pastors to take once every 7 years, and at 10 years into ministry, I am ready for a time of rest. So I'm delighted to introduce today the different preachers and pastors who will be with Trinity throughout the fall, September, October, and November. First, in September, we will welcome the Reverend George Hackey, who is a retired UMC minister. He and his wife worship at Asbury UMC, our sister Methodist church right here in Germantown. Reverend Hackey is a lifetime resident of Montgomery County and was actually a Montgomery County police officer for 29 years before becoming a minister. He was the 10th African American hired by the department, where he worked mostly in special ops, and he's received many awards and accolades for his community work while as a police officer. But when he could not resist the call of God anymore, he became a pastor and served vibrant congregations like Sharp Street, UMC, and Metropolitan, finally retiring in 2019. When you meet him, you'll want to ask him about being the first African American inducted into Montgomery College's Athletic Hall of Fame, about the backpack ministry he began serving 200 kids in the community, the City of Jerusalem Project, and the ways that he and Asbury UMC are serving the Germantown community today. We are beyond blessed to welcome Reverend George Hackey in September. In October, we will welcome back the Reverend Joy Jones, who has preached for us at Trinity before. She is a now retired Methodist clergy person who served churches in Washington, D.C., Baltimore, and Silver Spring for 21 years. Before being called into ministry, Reverend Jones was in science. She was a researcher, a teacher, and a science administrator at NIH. She's a daughter of missionaries in Burma, a granddaughter of a UMC pastor, and so she's been Methodist all her life. Now she lives in Gaithersburg with her little white dog, Dixie. She loves to read, sail, and travel, and having visited Australia, New Zealand, and the Galapagos Island, plus sailing in the Bahamas and Scotland since retiring, her really big plan is Antarctica next year. So you'll want to ask her about that. Hopefully COVID will not postpone that trip any longer. Reverend Joy comes to Trinity with a lot of joy, and we are grateful to welcome her back. Finally, in November, we'll get to hear from one of our very own. Philip Harris joined Trinity in early 2021. He was our first new member during the pandemic. Philip served as a licensed local pastor in a Methodist church out in the Midwest before moving to Maryland last year. He is now a doctoral student at Wesley Seminary in DC and the father of a brand new baby boy who is just a few weeks old. Philip has been my co-teacher throughout our series on the Book of Acts and the Cross and the Lynching Tree study. A native of Texas, Philip brings with him an interest in justice and diverse ministry experiences around the country. We're so thankful that God brought Philip to Trinity at just the right time. And finally, I'm reintroducing to you Pastor Kristen Cooper, who will be on call for pastoral emergencies throughout these 3 months. Kristen is the pastor of Soup Church and the owner of Coop Soups. She's on the cutting edge of church ministry, what it might look like in the future, as she leads a dinner church that welcomes many who have never felt quite at home in a church building. Kristen has been involved with Trinity for many years in different ways, and now she will be available to you as your pastor while I'm away. She is an insightful and loving person who is eager to connect with you. Now, while these pastors will serve as our guest preachers, and will be telling us the stories that move us, the stories of God, They are also going to help us tell our stories. And by that, I mean your stories. Each of these guest preachers will work with 3 to 4 Trinity members each month and kind of coach you in telling a piece of your story. Your story that moves us, that relates to our theme of stories that move us to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with our God. The last Sunday of each month in worship, we will have a kind of storytelling celebration and get to hear the 5-minute or less stories from 3 or 4 Trinity members. So I'm a little bit envious of all the gifts that these preachers will bring, that the messages, the words, the stories that they will tell and that you will tell. But I look forward to joining you again in December to celebrate Advent and Christmas together.
All who are thirsty.